So, this is the fundamentals of software testing, and now the introduction to software testing. Let's first talk about a bit software crisis. The term itself was found in 1968 when some software engineers were meeting each other in Germany. And by that time, software engineering was a very, very young discipline, although it is still a very young discipline. It was younger back then. Yet programs were starting to be large, and not tools, techniques, nor processes had improved fast enough. So there was crisis. And the crisis was appearing when projects were running over budget and running over time. Software was not very efficient. It was quite inefficient. Software was considered low quality. Software often did not meet requirements, projects were unmanageable, and code was not maintainable. Software was never delivered. So these were the things that made the crisis happening. But if you think about software development today, all of these are still there in some way. So there was definitely need for better processes. And already in 1970s, the programs were so huge that not only one person could handle them completely. You need a bigger team to build the software. And there was really need for processes to help avoiding their recent problems. So software testing really saw daylight back then. It was something like 50 years ago, so since then testing has become more professional and systematic, and is now considered as one of the key elements in software engineering. So in 50 years there has happened a lot. Let's see what was the software testing described in 50s. So McCracken told that what is software testing? So make sure the program runs, make sure the program solves the problem. So the program is compiled, then it tested, it runs, and if it solves the problem, then it's okay. So there is no anything else. Is the user interface okay, etc. These things were not considered. In the 70s, testing is an activity that increases our assurance or belief that program performs as it should. Now it was already noticed that testing is activity. So it's something that can be formally described. And still it's something that program performs as it should. That's the other part. In the end of the 70s, it was mentioned that testing is the process of executing program with the intent of finding errors. So testing is a process, and the thing is not to make sure program solves the problem, but it's the intent of finding errors, which is completely different thing. That's testing. In the 80s, testing is any activity aimed at evaluating an attribute of a program or system. Testing is the measurement of software quality. Okay, now there is a thing that is measurement and it measures software quality. In the 90s, testing is an unnecessary and unproductive activity if its sole purpose is to validate that the specifications were implemented as written. So that's not testing. Testing as performed in the most organization is a process designed to compensate for an ineffective software development process. So development process is bad, and by testing we try to compensate it. It is unrealistic to develop software and not test it, the perfect development process does not exist. So there will be always errors and bugs, and software needs to be tested. So evolution of definition of software testing continues. Testing is the process by which we explore and understand status of benefits and the risk associated with release of software system. So in the end of the 1990s, testing is exploring and understanding the status and understanding how much there are risks if we release the software right now. Testing is a concurrent lifecycle process of engineering, using and maintaining testware in order to measure and improve the quality of the software being tested. So, in the beginning of this millennium, software engineering understood that testing requires testware, which is basically software that is designed with parameters that it's like a test environment. So you cannot test everything in a product environment. Of course, that was understood even earlier. Testware to describe all software testing related work products, including test procedures, test data, test specification, and test reports, among other things. So test data, that's one thing. Tests produces a lot of data, and that by analyzing that data you can do a lot of things. In the 1970s these things were not considered. So software testing is an assessment of design, not of the quality of manufacture of the copy. It is an empirical and technical investigation conducted to provide stakeholders with information about the quality of the product or service under test. So we are assessing the design and to provide stakeholders with information. So testing is not just a thing that programmers do, but it's something that other stakeholders are interested in. So we are providing not just data, but information to them. Testing is a strategic tool for risk control. So there might be risks when releasing a software, so by testing we can reduce the level of risk we are taking when we are releasing a software. How is testing related to quality management and such? So if we think about the term quality management, it includes quality assurance. These are the tasks that are done beforehand, and then quality control, which is things that are done when there is something already done. And testing is almost all done in the quality control phase, such as usability testing, but also some things can be tested in quality assurance phase. For example, regression testing, more of these come in later videos. And here is a quite nice, at least quite green picture, how this quality management is made from quality assurance and quality control and testing inside them. This course is about testing, but it's related to quality management. And we have different viewpoints of testing. Different courses and sources emphasize different viewpoint of testing. Of course, there is one way is analytical. Behavior is like specs. So if everything works like specs, then it's okay. There are formal methods and modeling. This is quite, almost mathematical. Then there is a routine. Testing is a part of the job that requirements are met. So you just test its routine. And you measure the progression, cost and standards, automation, outsourcing. Yeah, you could outsource all the testing process, but that's one big question if it's wise at all. Then quality. Testing makes your software is high quality. That's one good point. And characteristics are processes, standards, supervision, and project management. Then there is a context-driven way. Testing produces knowledge to development. So human resources find the faults, most important stakeholders, investigate testing. These are the key elements there. And this was based on these guys. Testing, software testing, it is of course related to programming, but it's not related to this. So like this, programming and testing, they are not completely different things. They are more like this. So programming and testing, they are somewhat combined. They are related to each other. So programmer does testing, of course, but also separate testers exist. So if you are finding a new job, you can end up being tester that only does testing. That's one job in the software industry. The bigger the project, the more improved testing team. So you, really, there can be testing team with tens of people. If we think this a bit further, testing is not just part in a programming, but it's part of software development in a big way. So testing should not be thought as a sidekick cost, but value adding part of the software project and life cycle. And this has really changed from the 70s when testing was introduced. It was basically the last step before the product was released, but now it's task and step that is it is there for the whole software project from the beginning to the end. If we have a fault in a well, if you have a fault that slipped into production, it's 100 times it costs 100 times more than if we have found out the mistake already in analysis phase. And in design, it's twice as cost and in analysis, and in development 10 times, in testing 15. But if it's find out in product, then it's 100 times more the cost. So testing is not a cause, but a process to reduce costs. And that's one thing to understand, that we don't want to save money in testing. That's something that just produces costs if we are saving from testing. So the cost of the fault. Software testing is present in all software engineering from the beginning until the end. But in a real life, testing is restricted by money, time, human resources, or other resources. So if there is a fixed deadline, then there might be not enough time for testing, and that's sad, because already 15% of the optimal resources would produce enough basic testing. So if you have a project that takes 100 days, if you can spend 15 days for testing, it can make sure that there is the quality is probably enough. But if you need to skip it and you can spend, let's say, 2 days for testing, then the quality is definitely not enough. For example, in the USA, there has been almost $60 billion losses because the software is has not been tested enough. And yeah, 60 million losses because customers have been complaining. So if you put money to testing, you could actually save $22 billion. And that's even that's so big number. You could save in a software business so much that it would be more than the whole music business in total globally, which is something like $20 billion. And remember that the cost of a fixed in design is around 1% of the cost when the fault is found in productions, and customers are really complaining when the faults are in production. What has happened during this millennium? So the success rate of the software project have increased slightly according to Standish Group. So but still, if you watch this figure, less than 50% of the software projects are successful. And by challenge it, we mean a project that has some problems, and failed project have been ended before they went into production. But at least it has not gotten any worse. It's a bit better situation now than it was in the 90s. Yeah, but still, almost 50% of software projects are cancelled before they get finished. That's sad. And if you watch the other figure, so programs are still not in time. So something like 75% of the projects are not in time. Cost estimate is exceeded. Over 50% of the cases, there is more money required than in the first phase was thought. And there are features missing. So basically, something like 30% of the features are missing and 67% are delivered. Numbers are getting better, very slightly though. And this is also from the Standish Group. Aim of the software project. Usually it is wanted that the product is ready on time, is ready on its budget, includes all the wanted features, has quality high enough, which is very subjective topic sometimes. What is high quality? Who can tell? Produces the expected user experience. For example, is some game funny? User experience should be funny in that cases. And you want to verificate the software projects. Are we building the thing right? Which means, is it developed okay? Does it work? And you want to also validate the product. Are you building the right thing? Is this what the customer really wanted? There is no sense to build a software that is not wanted by the customer. Some basic concepts. We talk about faults, flaws, errors, bugs, mistakes. Many terms describing that software is not working as it should. So error, bug, that is a mistake in source code that makes program work as it is not supposed to. Fault, because of a bug, program ends up in a situation which is against its design. And failure, externally notable system behavior resulted by a fault. So if you go to facebook.com and it gives you just white screen, then there is a failure that is resulted from a fault. And there is a typo. Definitions of these terms have not yet stabilized. And if we are speaking about bug, we can describing a coding typo or user error or whatever. It depends on who is speaking and with whom. So, testing tasks. Testing is a systematic hunting for errors. So it's not random attempt to validate the functionality. With testing, you want to break the software. You want to find some errors. And the error hunting can be conducted in any phase of the software development. In the design phase, while programming, then in production use. In any of these cases, you can find errors. Of course, the earlier you find it, the better. Succeeded testing finds errors. There is no software that has no errors. Every software has errors. And testing can never be complete. But you need to still stop it sometime, but it cannot be completed. And the testing starts with planning, of course. What we are testing, what tools we are using for the testing. Then we set up the environment. There is a testware. There is a test server, these kind of things. Then there is actual testing. Testers use the program, and they produce some kind of a document, and that results are then reviewed. And then they can find some mismatches. So specification and the product, they are not the same. So which one is incorrect? Who knows? Was the product built like it was written in specification, or is the product what the customer wanted? Usually the product needs to be redone if it does not meet the specification. But there can be cases that the product itself is okay, but there is a design mistake. With systematic testing, errors and anomalies can be found, and in the end the product meets specification. Then there are different kind of faults, like functional faults. Which are product does not work, does not a thing that it is required to do. Product acts incorrectly, so it produces wrong outputs. These are functional faults. There is something that is not functioning right. Then there are usability errors. Product is hard to use. It's illogical or guides user wrongly. The user experience is not what is wanted, like the game is not funny. Performance problems. Performance is not it's insufficient. Software is slow. There is typo also. Quality problems. Quality is not high enough. Edges are off. Icons are ugly. Value of testing. Faults can be found through testing. And the testing gives an estimate of the quality of a product. And it produces data / information to improve the product further. And it also produces data / information to improve the organization work processes. Eases the development of software by pinpointing problems and weak parts. And you must remember that testing is not cost but value adding part of the software project. In real life, the testing means different things in different levels of organization, of course. Managers test and speak different things than programmers. Testing can be divided into two parts, planning and organizing of testing, and then the conducting the actual testing. Planning and organizing can be taught in courses like this. In these videos I'm teaching how to organize, how to plan testing. This is then common knowledge how things should be done. Actual testing varies in different organizations and can be learned by doing. Companies, of course, have their own tools and processes. And As I mentioned, complete testing is impossible. Let's consider a little example here. Program, let's say a web page that asks a user's name and age. So there are three fields, first name, last name and age. All fields have to be filled in. First, test with normal values. So it's one test case. You put first name Erno, last name Vanhala, age 82. I'm not 82, but I'm putting 82 there. And it's normal values, and it's the first test case. Then you test it with no values in some fields. You get 7 more test cases. Then test with two big slash large values in some fields. 7 more test cases. Two low short values. 7 more test cases. And if you already do these test cases with combination of these, you get 64 test cases. Name should not have numbers, and age should not accept letters. 0 should not be accepted, and name should be at least one character length. Name should not accept double quotation mark, and number not hexadecimals. So combination of all of these above, 343 test cases. Let's continue. And the web form should work with Firefox, Chrome, Safari and Edge. So we are multiplying the test cases by 4. Within Linux, Windows and macOS. Let's assume all browsers exist in all platforms, and thus we are just multiplying by 3. And also with mobile versions of browsers, multiply by 2. With Android, iOS, Sailfish and KaiOS, and multiply by 4. Combination of all these above. 32,000 test cases, almost 33,000. So if one test case takes 10 seconds, it usually takes like a minute or 5 minutes. Whole testing takes around 91 hours, so over 2 working weeks, almost 3. And this was only an extremely simple web form with 3 input fields. If you want to test it, this was even not complete testing, but somewhat complete testing. So in real life, complete testing is always impossible. Conclusion. Testing is an important part of a software project. There exists many levels of testing. There are plenty of different tools. And building 100% perfect software is not possible. Software projects suffer the same problems than in the 1970s, although the situation has not worsened but got better. We have many techniques, processes, tools, formal methods to test software, and that's a good thing. But there are still plenty of rooms for improvement.